Hello student, today I am starting new chapter. It is called AC analysis. Okay, electromagnetic induction already completed. Okay, now today I am starting a new chapter, last chapter of related to current here. Current. Okay, this is from this chapter you will get one question at least 5 marks. At least it may be 8 marks also. This is very important chapter. Name of this chapter is AC analysis. Till now we have discussed about DC current, how we can measure the DC current, and electromagnetic induction we have discussed about how change of magnetic field produce and current, okay, or change of we can say induced current or induced EMF. And in the one topic in electromagnetic induction, I derive one equation when the angle is with me. We know that phi equal to b dot s. Okay, now when angle is changing, it means magnetic field B and area is same, but angle is changing. In that case, we got an induced EMF. The expression of induced EMF, you must remember, we got E equal to E naught sine omega t. So E is a function of sine omega t. It means it is alternating, sinusoidal function. Okay. If we draw the graph, we will get sinusoidal graph, and E naught is the maximum level. So now DC, you see in this figure, DC current, it is along x-axis, positive x-axis, we have time, taken time, okay, this is origin, and along positive y-axis, we have taken current. If we plot, we will get this type of straight line in case of DC current. It is fixed with respect to time, the amplitude or maximum current flowing through a circuit is always fixed. It means it does not change in. Means peak value or maximum value is always this much only. Okay, it does not change with respect to time. But in case of alternating current, that's why we are calling it alternating. See this figure. As the time passes, the value of the current is changing. This is called positive half cycle. This is called negative half cycle. Okay, this is called positive peak. It is denoted by I naught. And here it is called negative peak, its value is C, it is denoted by minus I naught. Okay, so this current is called alternating current. It means up to certain time we are getting positive value, after some time up to certain time we will get negative value. Okay, so this is called alternating current. Okay, now first, in alternating current, we have to know this term related to amplitude, cycle. What is cycle? Time period, frequency, phase, and phase difference. Now, what is amplitude? Now, maximum value of the AC current or peak value. Okay, it's called amplitude. Here, you see in this figure, the current is increasing like this. The maximum value of the current is reaching at this point. At when it reach at P point, is this maximum value is denoted by I naught. Okay, this is called peak current or amplitude of this current, AC current. Okay, it is generally denoted by like this equation. If there is a phase difference is 0, I equal to I naught sine omega t. Okay, or if there is phase, I equal to I naught sine omega t plus phi. Omega is the angular frequency, t is the time, and phi is the phase, initial phase. Okay, so if there is initial phase is 0, it means when the current is starting t equal to 0 time, then we say that there is no phase difference, so means initial phase is 0. In that case, for this figure, the equation will be I equal to I naught sine omega t. Okay, if there is a phase, initial phase, then we write I equal to I naught sine omega t plus phi. Now phi denotes the phase, and phase will measure by angle in radian unit. Okay, it may be pi by 2, pi by 4 like this. In case of alternating voltage also, we can write E equal to E naught sine omega t. If there is a phase, initial phase, omega t plus phi. If there is no phase, then omega t only. This is the basic equation of alternating current, okay, AC current. I equal to I naught sine omega t if there is no phase. If there is a phase, I equal to I naught sine omega t plus phi. You just memorize this. We will use this equation only. And alternating EMF is denoted by E equal to E naught sine omega t plus phi if there is a phase, initial phase. If there is no phase, then I equal to I, E equal to E naught sine omega t. Okay, here I naught is called amplitude or peak value or maximum value. Here E naught is called maximum value of EMF. Okay, now next is cycle. Now this is one positive half cycle. This is positive. Every cycle consists of one positive half cycle and one negative half cycle. So up to this much is called one cycle. Okay, so 0 to this is suppose R. Positive half cycle, negative half cycle consists of one cycle, consists of one positive half cycle, one negative half cycle. So this complete O to R path is called cycle. Next is time period. To complete one cycle, time required to complete one cycle is called time period. It is denoted by capital T letter. Okay. Next is frequency. Number of complete cycle per second is called frequency. You know this. A frequency is denoted by small f, f. Okay. Now f equal to, we know this formula, f equal to 1 by t time period. Okay, again t equal to, you know, t time period, t equal to 2 pi by omega. This is angular frequency. Okay, this is simple frequency, this is angular frequency. Unit of f is in SI system hertz, you remember. Okay, now next is phase. What is phase? It means when alternating signal means current here passing with respect to time, time elapsed, that difference from this origin is called phase. Okay, here phase is what? Zero. Initial phase is zero. If this signal is, means current is starting from here, then we can say there is a phase, and this phase is denoted by phi, and this phase generally measured by in radian unit. There is a phase. Okay. Now, what is next is very important, phase difference. If we have two alternating current like A and B, you see A is like this and B is starting from origin, and A is starting before t equal to 0 time. Okay. Now, IA equal to I naught sine omega t and IB equal to I naught sine omega t plus phi. Okay. Because here, as A start, this portion is negative. Okay. Now, what is phase difference between two alternating current or two alternating signal? You can say it is the time elapsed between two alternating signals when they reach at zero value or maximum value. Now you see it is zero but it is negative. So this signal means this current A, IA is lagging behind B, means it reached zero before it, A. B current, B alternating current reaching zero before A alternating current. So there is a phase difference. This phase difference is phi, and A is lagging behind B, or we can say B is leading, because B is B current, alternative current reaching A before reaching zero, B alternating current before A alternating current, because it is negative. This much is zero. When it reach zero, this B alternating reach here at this position, ओके, और यू कैन से व्हेन इट रीच ए अल्टरनेटिंग करंट रीच पीक पोजीशन, ओके एट दिस टाइम, बट इट रीच एट द सेम टाइम इट रीच दिस पोजीशन, ओके सो इट नीड सम टाइम, मींस वी कैन से दैट बी अल्टरनेटिंग करंट रीचिंग फर्स्ट रीचिंग बिफोर मैक्सिमम पोजीशन बिफोर ए अल्टरनेटिंग करंट रीच, मींस देयर इज अ फेज डिफरेंस, सो हियर वी कैन से ए इज लैगिंग बिहाइंड बी करंट, और वी कैन से बी इज लीडिंग एंड बी इज लीडिंग कंपेयर टू ए अल्टरनेटिंग, देयर इज अ फेज डिफरेंस, दैट्स व्हाई वी आर राइटिंग आई बी इक्वल टू आई नॉट साइन ओमेगा टी प्लस, दिस इज द फेज डिफरेंस बिटवीन दिस टू अल्टरनेटिंग करंट, ओके एंड वी कैन मेजर दिस फेज डिफरेंस बाय दिस phi, we can denote and we can measure by angle between this, okay. Now simply you can measure phase. See this figure, when current reach at P point, what is the phase? In radian unit, pi by 2. In terms of time, t equal to capital T by 4, okay, this is the phase of this alternating current when it reach P, okay. Now when it reach at zero position again, what is the phase at this position in terms of angle pi, in terms of time capital T by 2. So in this way you can measure the phase either in terms of time, okay, time period, or either in terms of angle, okay. Maximum time we can measure the phase with respect to angle and in radian unit, okay. So for time being, this is the first class. You just go through this. I will give notes regarding this AC analysis, okay. So you have to know all these terms first, okay.